Boo. It's me, Louise. Yes, it is me. I know you can't recognize me that much. I don't have makeup on. Weird. It's crazy. There's an airplane. And my air conditioning is on. Yep, this is how my life is going. Hey guys, it's me. I hope you don't mind the air conditioning on. It's really hot, and it's only gonna get hotter as the weekend goes on. And so forgive me if you can hear it. Hopefully it's just like white noise. But I am on here today for a different type of video. Hence why I'm not wearing makeup. And if you see the title, it is a chit chat get ready with me, because why not? I was sitting here doing my makeup and I was like, I don't feel like thinking. I don't feel like just listening to music, because I'm gonna tell you right now, I am stressed beyond reason about this trip coming up for me. It's only in a couple of days, and now the stress is starting to get to me, and the packing, and just the everything to do when you're going across the country. So yeah, I am stressed, and I was like, I feel like talking. I just feel like being at peace for once, and so I thought I would turn this on and get ready with you guys and just chit chat about what I'm doing and whatever else pops in this head of mine. And yeah, I have my water because I am thirsty. Your girl's thirsty. So I'm standing, obviously, and there's not a mirror behind me, so I have this mirror. And I'm just gonna be kind of pretty much doing it right here so you can see what I'm doing. And this is my everyday daily makeup, basically. I do usually wear makeup, and it's not because of any reason that people want to come up with, or, you know, like, girls wear makeup because they're insecure. No. I like makeup. I have since I was like 12, and yeah, I just like wearing it. So like I said, I was already starting to do my makeup, and so I already have foundation, and I filled in my eyebrows because yeah, and those are the two longest steps anyway, which, so I'm kind of like happy I thought about it after the fact. But I will still tell you what I did if any of you are interested. So all my stuff is right here, so I'm going to be moving back and forth, so I don't know how relaxing this is going to be, but I hope you enjoy anyway. Okay, also, if anyone gets the reference, please, please. Okay, so. I guess basically the first couple of things that I'm going to start with is I used this primer, and it's Maybelline New York Master Prime for blur and redness control. Now, I'm gonna be honest with you, I have really weird skin. My face is very, very red, and it has been since I was like in middle school. It's the weirdest thing. I don't know if it's rosacea, but it's just always red. And I know a lot of people have this, but I guess I myself haven't really looked into it as much as I should have. But it's just kind of just, you know, it's red and it's a different color than my actual skin. So it kind of is annoying. It's kind of hard to find makeup that covers it first of all, but then also matches well enough, because darker foundations usually cover up redness better. So when I use a lighter one, it kind of just doesn't cover up the redness, unfortunately. So I usually try to use as many red control products to help with that, and this one actually helps a lot. Most of my makeup is drugstore, sue me. I am not the, I would love expensive makeup, actually, don't get me wrong, I would. Other stuff comes first, unfortunately, but this one's really good. It's in the shade 300. So I used that. I just got a new bottle, so that's what I used. And then for concealer, I actually have two concealers. So I use this CoverGirl Ready Set Gorgeous concealer for under my eyes and whatever like little things I have on my face. I break out sometimes, but it's annoying because the redness kind of looks like I'm breaking out more than I am. But my skin's starting to calm down now. Like, I don't break out as much. So I use this, and it's just like that. It's a little applicator. So I use that. And then for foundation, I use this new, I don't know, it's a couple months new, I think. A couple months old. It's Maybelline Superstay Full Coverage Foundation. And I picked the shade 110 Porcelain because I had a lighter one. So I had a light one, which was 102, and it was way too light. And then I got 112, which was a little, well, it'll be good for the summer, but I'm still not tan or red or anything yet. So I got the one in the middle, and it works pretty well. Like, I have it on right now with no bronzer, no contour, or no powder or anything. It's just the actual foundation, and it looks good enough. So yeah, I used that. And then, for my eyebrows, just to get it out of the way, I use this brow kit. It's very dirty, and we can open it and see that it's very used. This is the lightest shade, obviously. It's light brown. Awesome! And then, sometimes I dip into this one, just because, I don't know, I guess I like my brows a little darker. I'm blonde. My eyebrow color is blonde, so I like to fill it in just so it doesn't look like I have no brows and no expression on my face. And then to clean up my brows so they have that lovely clean arch and everything, I use this CoverGirl concealer. So it's just like a screw one, and it's like that, so I can just clean it up very easily. So that's that. So that's everything I've done so far. So now we can actually get into getting ready, because I need to get ready and go places, guys. Alright. So now I'm going to take my Photo Focus eyeshadow primer from Wet n Wild. It's very cheap, and I don't really care, I guess, because it's kind of sticky, and I don't know, just cheap enough that it stays on and makes my eyeshadow stay on. So yeah, I just do that. Oh wow. See? You can see the redness already. It looks purple. Everyone has their things, right? Okay. So now is the fun part. Eyeshadow. For this, I go in with the most expensive thing I do own, and that is this Morphe eyeshadow palette. And usually I use like a drugstore palette, like I have a bunch of other ones, but I thought I'd bust out this one. So those are all the colors. So pretty. I love it. This is more fall colors, that's why I've been using lighter colors and everything, but I think for today, should I wear this today? I think I'm gonna wear this today. Then we're just gonna do a natural, like, nude eye, I guess. So I'm gonna go in with this color right there. Dip, 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 dip. Shake it up. This is gonna suck to be able to, like, keep picking it up and putting it back down. You gotta do what you gotta do. So I'm getting all my like last minute stuff done. I'm pretty much packing last minute, which sucks. But it's also kind of like you have to wait till the last minute because the weather in Ireland changes so frequently. Like a week ago, it was raining every day, and now it's only raining like sometimes, and then other days are sunny. Yeah, so I kind of had to wait to get my outfits ready, but I'm very excited and it's gonna be worth it. Hopefully. Okay, now we'll do the other eye. I'm just gonna say right now that I never said I was good at makeup. I never said that I was a beauty guru. Or that I really know what I'm doing. I know some techniques and stuff, but I just do what works for me, you know? Because, I mean, everyone does their stuff differently. I just work on blending and just kind of making it look good, I guess. If this is considered good. If anyone has any recommendations on, redness, like how to get rid of redness on the face and stuff like that, please let me know because it's kind of getting old. Like I do use BB cream and stuff, but I mean that doesn't really help because the redness is so overwhelming sometimes. So now I'm gonna go in with this black, just kidding. Could you imagine? Hey guys, I'm a raccoon today. Well, we did that. I don't know. I might change my shirt actually because nothing looks good with yellow. But then again, I don't really care. I'm just doing errands today and relaxing. I think we're actually gonna go in with, I don't know. I wish you guys could help me. I think we're just gonna go in with this shade right here. Yeah, this little shimmery one. Because nothing's really gonna match well. If I wasn't wearing this shirt, it probably would look really good. Feel free to let me know what your plans for the summer is. I know this is like, this trip is probably the biggest thing this summer. I mean, it's already July almost, so it was our midsummer plan. Oh my gosh, look at that actually. It looks very severe on camera. This was not the best idea, was it? Well. I also don't know when this video is going up. I'm filming this, like I said, a couple days before I actually leave. So, I don't know. I want to upload this while I'm in Ireland. So I might do that actually. We'll see, guys. We'll see. Just so you guys have something, because I don't like the idea of 2 weeks of no video, you know? Wonder if this will work. Will this work? I don't like that. Okay, so that's all I'm doing really for the eyes. With this palette. Like I said, I just want to make it. Well, I was supposed to be natural, but I also like red, like a red eye. I don't know. I don't know what I'm talking about. Just, oh my gosh, don't listen to me. Now we're gonna go in. I use this for multiple things, but I go in with the Rimmel London highlight contour blush palette, and I take the highlight and put it on my brow bone just because I really like the shade. So I keep forgetting the mirror, but I can use you, can't I? I'm just gonna use you, hope you don't mind. I feel like this blends it together better too. Just a nice shimmer, and it doesn't look as harsh, I guess. There's also a big mirror right here, and I look crazy. I'm wearing pink shorts, guys, and a yellow shirt. So, you can imagine how crazy I look in a big mirror. So yeah, like I said, I'm just finishing up everything, going to the store later. My mom just went to get highlights. I'm getting my nails redone tomorrow. Just last minute touches to make everything good, and I'm so excited. My boyfriend is so excited. He's coming to meet my whole family. I don't know if I've said that, but everyone on my mom's side is in Ireland, so he's coming to meet all of them, and yeah, it's gonna be very intimidating, so I feel kind of bad, but at the same time, it's like me, I'm re-meeting all of them because I haven't seen them in 11 years, and so we're all gonna be kind of just getting to know each other again. So yeah. Okay, now that I'm done with that. Just kidding, I'm not done with that. I go back in to the palette, and I usually do a little bit with a different brush under the eye. It sounds like I don't know anything about makeup, like the way I'm talking, but I swear I do. I'm just a little scatterbrained. I'm just gonna go in with this brown right here. The colors look different on camera. That's weird. I wonder if this will work. Actually, yeah, this might work. I'm gonna do this. No, this doesn't work. There we go. I always find it funny, the faces that people make. I like that. When they're doing their makeup. It looks red, but it's not. Or maybe it is, and I'm just colorblind. Whatever. I'm just gonna make it worse, but I'm going with a darker brown and seeing if I can fix that. A little bit. Oh gosh. I hope everyone. Oh my god. Please, somebody make that a meme. Someone, just someone. Capture that moment. I just poked myself in the eye. This is a mess. I like how this is going. Okay. So that's all done. Eye is poked. Eyes are watery. We're good. So now, after all of that nonsense, I go in with powder finally for my face, and I do the Milani. This one's old, I just got a new one, so I'll show you this. The Milani base powder in 02, which is nude, and it's Conceal and Perfect Shine Proof powder. My face gets oily in the summer a lot, actually, so I just go in. This one has a mirror, oh my gosh. So I just go in with this and kind of, not a lot, just over my forehead, like I get oily right here, and my cheek. And then other cheek. My nose, I get oily, so I just makeup tends to like fly off my chin. Is that weird? It's already starting to crack. I think I just waited too long to put on powder. And then of course you just go down the neck a little bit. Just to blend it together. Look at me actually sounding like I know what I'm doing. I realized the other day that if I do something, it actually helps a lot. So in the places that I do get oily, I take this Airspun loose face powder and I just put it in the places that I get very oily. This is a white powder. I got it in white. So, in pictures it might look weird if you put this all over your face, but I just put it in the places where I get oily. And I feel like it sets it a lot better. It might just be an illusion, I don't know. If you want to take some of my advice, please feel free, but then you don't have to. So I do that. I forgot to include that one. And now, after that is all set and just powdery, I go in with my highlight and contour, which is my favorite part. So I start with the highlight. I wish I had time to edit this and like cut it and just make it so funny. But this is an ASMR channel, so we can't do that. And then I just put it, oh, what am I using? Miss Rose Shimmer Highlight. 03, I don't know. I don't know where I got this. That's what it looks like. I know it was cheap. I think I just got it probably at Walgreens or something. And I go in with like an angled brush. I don't know. It's just a brush that works for me. I go in with that and just put some highlight on the cheekbone. Should probably totally use the mirror for this part, but and then I go down the bridge of my nose, like that. It usually doesn't make that much of a difference. And then I do the tip of my nose. Just like that. And then I do my Cupid's bow right here. There's also a hair on this and it's tickling me. Actually don't contour my nose. A lot of people do. I just don't really care. I feel like I don't have a horrible nose. So what I do is I go back in with this and I just kind of, which doesn't make much of a difference at all, I don't think, but just do that. And then I take the brown shade, the contouring shade, with this fluffier angled brush from e.l.f. Both this brush and this powder brush is from e.l.f. Very cheap, but gets the job done. And now I'm gonna use my mirror because heaven knows I do not want a harsh contour. So I just go in like that. Oh wow, does that? I don't know. Everything shows up a little different on camera, I feel. So, the other side. I just blend it. Blend. And then, last but not least, well, I guess I do a little bit on my forehead. I just kind of dab it around my forehead. Hi, there's a camera there. I can't really cover you. Kind of get it in my hair too, because that's what we like to do. And then last but not least, I go along the jawline a little bit. Just a little bit. Nothing too crazy. Just to sharpen the definition a little bit. Okay. And when all of that is set on the face, I take one last look, and I say, could have done better, but this is as good enough as we're gonna get. So. Then I do take this setting spray that I found that I really, really like. It's Milani Make It Last Setting Spray. And it's not that big. It's only 2.03 ounces, but it smells really good and it's good for travel. So I take this, put my hair back, and I just spray it on that face, and yeah. Really nice, actually. And I just fan it out. Okay, that's great. I didn't forget. I'm weird and I just set my face before I do my mascara. I don't know why. But I just picked this up yesterday and it's the CoverGirl Lash Blast Volume Waterproof. I didn't want it in waterproof, but this was the only black that they had. So we got that. And then we just put it on our lashes. I don't have the worst lashes actually, but I actually like this. I usually use the CoverGirl Lash Blast Fusion. That's the one I usually use. But it was like $10 and I was like, you know, I have a lot of other stuff to buy. I don't want to spend $10 on a mascara anymore. I know, I'm cheap. I was taught to always save my money the best I can. And go for the best deals. So. Doesn't look terrible, actually. I like this. The only thing about waterproof is that, obviously, it's hard to get off because it's waterproof, but I think it's worth it. What do you think? Yes? No? Maybe so. So, yeah. Then I go in on the other side. I look so like, ugh. How to do this. I always stand while I do my makeup. Is that weird? I feel like that's kind of weird. So when I'm doing my makeup, I use the mirror right next to me, like that one. And I just do my makeup, and I have a big dresser right here, and everything's on it, and I feel like a lot of people would want to sit while they do their makeup, but not I. Just feel like I'm in more control when I'm standing. What's happening? I can't tell. Can't really tell on camera if it's that great, but it looks decent enough. So then I'm just gonna go over with another coat. Just to flare them out a little bit. Like I said, this is the first time I'm using this one, so I'm not familiar with it. And then we go in with the bottom lashes. I always get scared for the bottom. Because I don't want it to be too spidery. Looks bright, right? Right. Sure. If I ever do this again, I need there to be a mirror behind me. Because this holding a mirror up thing is not working for me. Oh wow, I look crazy. Why do I look so different? Maybe this wasn't how it was supposed to go. So now we're changing it up a little bit because now I'm realizing that this looks a little weird. To me, at least. So I'm going in with a little bit of eyeliner to darken it up a little bit. Don't mind my face. Oh gosh, don't mind my face. Yeah, this was definitely a fail because the lighting is really throwing me off. And everything's starting to look a little different than how I thought it would be. Now I can't find my brush. Fun. But last but not least, I go in to the inner corner and I put some highlight right there. Actually, I guess this is like a going out look. So I guess it really wasn't a fail, but just wasn't what I was going for. But I hope you guys enjoyed my rambling and whatever else was happening. I look like I'm going out. But yeah. Thanks for sticking with me while I discover my inner rocker, because that's what I look like. I have two hair clips in my hair, actually. I think that's it. I believe that's it. So, thank you guys for joining me, and thank you for not leaving horrible comments below, because I know you wouldn't do that to me. If you don't agree with stuff that I did, then that's fine. But I did forget one thing, and that is lips, because I am all over the place. But we are going in with L'Oreal Paris Infallible Never Fail Lip Liner. And this is in the shade Coral. So I never really used a lip liner before, but actually don't hate how this looks on me. I already have pretty thick lips, so I don't overline them as much. But yeah, I go in with that. And then I was thinking of doing this shade. It's Blushing Pouch. So I think I'm gonna do this. I just got this the other day. That definitely is a look. Probably not the best look. Probably not, doesn't match the best, but we're just gonna go with that. I don't even know if I should post this, because this isn't, this didn't go how I wanted it to, but I will ask you if I should. And if you see this video, then I should. So, thank you for joining me. And that is it. And it took me a very long time because I've been talking, because I'm a chatterbox. I love you guys, and I will see you very, very, very soon. Well, not very soon, but soon enough.